वेलकम बैक स्टूडेंट्स स्टूडेंट्स वी वर स्टडिंग चैप्टर नंबर 18 ऑफ सब्जेक्ट साइंस दैट इज पोल्यूशन ऑफ एयर एंड वॉटर. दिस इज योर लेक्चर नंबर 2. इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव लर्न दैट व्हाट इज एयर पोल्यूशन एंड व्हाट आर द सोर्सेज ऑफ एयर पोल्यूशन. And now we will discuss some more topics of this chapter that are effects of air pollution, acid rain, depletion of ozone layer and health problems. And after that, prevention of air pollution means how can we protect air to get polluted. Students, effects of air pollution are greenhouse effect and global warming. Second is acid rain. Third is depletion of ozone layer. And last is health problems. So, in the previous lecture, we have studied that what is greenhouse effect and global warming. So, in this lecture, we will start with the second effect, that is acid rain. Another harmful effect of air pollution is acid rain. Now, what is acid rain? The oxides of sulfur and nitrogen that are present in air react with atmospheric water vapors to form sulfuric acid and nitric acid respectively. It means oxides of sulfur and nitrogen which is released from the industries and factories react with atmospheric water vapors, means react with water vapors that are present in atmosphere and form sulfuric acid, means sulfur react with water vapor and form sulfuric acid, and nitrogen and water vapor together form nitric acid. And these acids, means sulfuric acid and nitric acid, mix with the rain water and making the rain acidic. And this is called acid rain. It means what? Basically, the rain water that contains oxides of sulfur and nitrogen is called acid rain. Now, what are the harmful effects of acid rain? One of the most harmful effects of acid rain can be seen at Taj Mahal, which is located in Agra. Experts have warned that pollutants in air are discoloring its white marble. Means the pollution has been discoloring its white marble because the industries located in and around Agra release pollutants like sulfur dioxide and nitrogen dioxide which react with water vapors to form acids and fall down as acid rain. And this results in discoloring and corrosion of white marble. So this is one of the most harmful effect of acid rain. Another harmful effects of acid rain are it destroys vegetation by making the soil acidic. Means when acid rain falls down on the soil, then it destroys the vegetation. So, destroys vegetation by making the soil acidic. Second is, it affects the survival of aquatic plants and animals. How? By making the water of lakes and ponds acidic. Means when the acidic rain, when the water of acidic rain mix with the water bodies like lakes and ponds, then it affects the aquatic plants because it reduces the amount of oxygen into water. That's why it affects the survival of aquatic plants and animals. Now third is corrosion of steel such as bridges. Means the chemicals which are present in acid rain can cause corrosion of steel such as bridges and erosion of stone statues. Okay, so these are some harmful effects of acid rain. And the reason of forming acid rain is air pollution, means the harmful gases which are present in air like sulfur and nitrogen, which is released from industries, factories. These gases are released from industries and factories, and they are responsible for the acid rain. Okay, so this is a effect of air pollution. Next effect of air pollution is depletion of ozone layer. See, we have already learned that chlorofluorocarbon is a source of air pollution. Okay, chlorofluorocarbon is the source of air pollution, and this chlorofluorocarbon gas are used in refrigerator air conditioners. Okay, these are used in refrigerators and air conditioners. So they damage the ozone layer of atmosphere. Means chlorofluorocarbon is responsible for damaging the ozone layer of atmosphere. But now the question is, why ozone layer is important to us? So the ozone layer is present in atmosphere, okay, and why it is important to us? It is very important to us because it absorbs harmful ultraviolet or UV radiations that are coming from the sun. Means ozone layer absorbs all the harmful ultraviolet radiations, okay, and these ultraviolet radiation are harmful for us. They can cause skin cancer and eye problems. Okay, that's why they are harmful for us. These are harmful rays, and the ozone layer absorbs these harmful rays that are coming from the sun. So think about it, if our ozone layer is damaged, then ultraviolet radiation enter into the atmosphere of the earth, which can cause skin cancer and eye problems. Okay, that's why ozone layer is very important to life, because it absorbs harmful ultraviolet radiations. Okay, so this is also an effect of air pollution. Because of air pollution, because of the source of air pollution, our ozone layer gets depleted. Next effect is health problems. Air pollutants can cause many kinds of health problems in humans. And some of the health problems caused by the air pollutants are, first is headache, means excess concentration of carbon monoxide. Okay, it is a harmful gas, so it can cause headache and nausea. Now, what is nausea? A feeling of sickness. Nausea is a feeling of sickness, like to vomit. Okay, so headache and nausea is caused by the air pollutants. And next is heart related problems, means long term exposure to harmful gases can cause heart related problems. Okay, and next is it can cause irritation in eyes, nose and throat, and it can also cause many respiratory problems like asthma and lung cancer. Means smoke causes breathing difficulties also, such as asthma and lung cancer. It means what? It can also cause many respiratory problems. It means air pollution also affects on our health. Okay, air pollutants can cause many kinds of health problems in humans. So students, these are four effects of air pollution: greenhouse effect and global warming, means increasing the earth's temperature. Second is acid rain. Third is depletion of ozone layer. And last is health problem. These are some bad effects of air pollution. Now the question is, how can we prevent the air to get polluted? So now we will study the prevention of air pollution. Students, air pollution can be reduced to a great extent in the following ways. Okay, first is by using fuels like CNG, means by using clean fuels like CNG. Full form of CNG is compressed natural gas, and LPG. LPG means L for liquefied, P for petroleum, G for gas. So by using clean fuels like CNG and LPG in vehicles, okay, we can prevent our air to get polluted. Second is by getting the exhaust of vehicles checked regularly. Means we should check the exhaust of vehicles like smoke, okay, smoke level, etc. regularly. Third is by installing tall chimneys in factories. Okay, tall chimneys should be installed in factories. Next is by using alternative source of energy like solar energy, wind energy instead of fossil fuels, because solar energy and wind energy do not produce any harmful gas. That's why we should use solar energy and wind energy instead of fossil fuels, because fuels produce many harmful gases and pollute the air. That's why instead of using fossil fuels, we should use solar energy and wind energy where it is possible. Okay, now next point is by planting trees. It is the best method to prevent the air. By planting trees, plant helps to make the air clean. That's why this is the best method to prevent our air. Now next point is by composting the organic waste rather than burning it. Means we should not burn the organic waste, because on burning it produces many harmful gases. That's why we should compost it instead of burning it. So by composting the organic waste, we can prevent our air. So these are some ways by which we can prevent our air. Means air pollution can be reduced by these ways. Okay, students, now we will discuss the homework solution of previous lecture. Question number 1 was multiple choice question. A part, the gas responsible for global warming is. So two gases are responsible for global warming that are called greenhouse gases. First is carbon dioxide and second is methane. So which gas is responsible for global warming? Carbon dioxide. This option is correct. Now B part is, the major causes of air pollution include. First is burning of coal and petroleum. Yes, this is a cause of air pollution. So first option is correct. C part is, the gas used in refrigerating appliance causing depletion of ozone layer is. So which gas is responsible for depletion of ozone layer? That is chlorofluorocarbon, and the short form of chlorofluorocarbon is CFC. C for chloro, F for fluoro, C for carbon. So chlorofluorocarbons. Okay, this gas is responsible for depletion of ozone layer. So second option is correct. Now D part is, greenhouse effect is. First part is, painting house in green color. No, this is not a greenhouse effect. Second is, having green room in house. No, it is also wrong. Third is increased earth's temperature. Yes, greenhouse effect is increased earth temperature. So this option is correct. Second question, fill in the blanks. A part is the incomplete combustion of fossil fuel produces dash gas. So the incomplete combustion of fossil fuels produces carbon monoxide gas. Answer is carbon monoxide gas. B part is dash and dash are greenhouse gases. So answer is carbon dioxide and methane gas are greenhouse gases. Third question, what are the substances that cause pollution? Coal. So the substances which cause pollution are called pollutants. Answer is pollutants. Question number 4 was, write the full form of CFC. So full form of CFC is chlorofluorocarbon. Okay, this is a gas which is released from refrigerators. So full form of CFC is chlorofluorocarbon. Question number 5, what is greenhouse effect? Answer is the natural phenomenon that is responsible for heating of the earth's surface and atmosphere is called greenhouse effect. So students, this is your homework. Question number 1 is fill in the blanks. A part, the dashed layer protects us from the harmful ultraviolet rays of the sun. B part, dash rain contains sulfuric acid and nitric acid. C part, alternative sources of energy are dash and dash. Question number 2, match the following. CFC, sulfuric acid, CNG. Question number 3, what is air pollution? List its sources, means write the sources of air pollution. Question number 4, list some ways for the prevention of air pollution. Question number 5, explain all the effects of air pollution. Just write the effects of air pollution. Okay, so there are 5 questions in today's homework. Do these questions in your fair notebook. Okay, so this ends for today's lecture. Thank you.